Now for our final presentation before intermission, please welcome Jodi Colella to talk about FiberLAB.
Yes. At FiberLAB, there's always something brewing. I'm sorry, pardon me the pun, but I couldn't resist. I love this photo of the pan. But what FiberLAB is a independent study group that provides individual instruction, exposure to contemporary art, and a membership to a maker community. We're a community of makers who are interested in investigating materials and processes. It's a place for experimentation. It happens in my studio. I open it up to its members. They are allowed to extend their interests and try out all sorts of things in my space with my materials, with my tools. I share my techniques, they share theirs. We have a wonderful time just learning from each other. We learn from each other while sharing what we already know. The most popular part of it is the beginning of each class when we have a sharing session where everyone talks about what they have been doing over the 2 week period that we had in between classes. They share their developments, they ask questions, we give gentle critiques and suggestions, and everybody sort of gives a lot of love and support from being in that environment. They're seeking a community to be able to share their art and feel safe while they're taking risks. And so everybody works independently and has their own body of work, but we also work globally. Here you can see that Melissa wanted to recreate her cat, so she decided to needle felt it. And here Rebecca is working with some weaving techniques. And we cover all sorts of activities. In the lab, we call it the lab because it's so experimental. Every week that we're together, there is some sort of global activity in the background. For instance, here we're doing echo dyeing, where we're taking the grape leaves from Amy's garden with some onion skins, and we're going to roll them up into bundles and put them into a dye bath. And then they'll let them stay with me for a while, and then when they come back, we open them up and have a wonderful surprise. And this is just part of the experiments that they, one of the experiments that they participate in. Here, we do a whole series of studies. We are constantly trying different techniques to see, not everything sticks for everybody. Some people like some techniques better than others. And the whole idea is to give a safe place where they can try out new things without feeling like they have to have a huge investment in resources or expense. They can, because they are using my tools and using my space, and we're sharing all of our experiences. Here are some more studies. Here's Amy. Amy has been really delving into rust dyeing, and she happens to be a master embroiderer. So she's incorporating her new discoveries with the rust dyeing on silk with couching and applique. And Rochelle loves to work in multiples, but very simply. She says she likes to do art that can be done on a couch. So here, she's been taking wire and crocheting around it in her different fiber supplies and creating that sort of massive, larger-than-life creation. Here's Rochelle with another one of her multiples, where she knit a million fingers and then put them together and created this art piece that is so much bigger than what she started with. Here's the wall of studies. You can see some of what we play with. It's all about play. You found fishing ropes with wire wrapping, weaving without a loom, picking up shells and seaweed where we happen to be that weekend. This is Sarah. Sarah's medium happens to be felted wool, but she's always pushing it. And here what she's doing is playing with felted wool and wax, experimenting for another project that she was interested in at the time. We have communal things all over the studio for people to play with. This rigid held loom is for anyone who wants to try their hand at a new medium, a new fiber, a new material to see what would happen when they weave it. This is my studio. This is where it all happens. I like to say this is sort of like the calm before the storm, because if you walked in the middle of one of our sessions, it would appear very chaotic, because everybody is so engaged and running around and laughing and talking. And I wanted to share that I'm taking all of this to Greece, where I'm teaching these techniques in Greece, in Skopelos. It's called Stitching Nature and Culture on a Greek Island, and it's all about us finding our place with the on the beaches of Skopelos, with the makers of Skopelos. And if you're interested in any of this, I have flyers in the back, sign-up sheets for FiberLAB and other workshops, and flyers about Greece. So thank you.